Welcome back to another video about hybrid storage and data migration with AWS Storage Gateway. Now, in this particular lab, we are going to review the lab architecture, and we will create a primary and a secondary S3 bucket, and we will enable cross-region replication. Then we will configure a file gateway and create an NFS file share. And we will mount the file share to the Linux instance and migrate the data. And then we will verify that the data is successfully migrated. So let's get into it. And then the first thing we will do is to basically start looking at the lab architecture here. As you can see, we have a three AWS region. We have US East 1, where we have an Amazon EC2 instance, and we will create an NFS file share with the AWS Storage Gateway service. And these will be replicated to two different S3 buckets. We have the Amazon S3 primary bucket in US East 2 and Amazon S3 bucket in US West 2. The primary bucket is going to get the data from the Linux host and copy it to this bucket. And the secondary one is going to be the target for the cross-region replication. And the idea behind the cross-region replication is if the bucket, the first bucket, is lost, we can get our data from the replicated secondary bucket. So the first thing we need to do in task two is to go to S3. And from S3, we are going to create a bucket. And let me call this first bucket. And I will give this the date of today. And we will create this bucket in US East 2. So this is will be here in Ohio, and then we will enable in this bucket versioning, and then we create a bucket. Next thing is going to create another bucket, and we are going to call this second bucket, and the date of today, which can give me an identical bucket name, which could be a unique across AWS region. And this is will be in US West 2. And we will enable as well versioning. Click on create bucket. And now we want to enable cross-region replication. Now when you enable cross-region replication, you want to enable it from the first bucket to be replicated to the second bucket. So let us now go and select the bucket that we have in Ohio, US East. And we need to go to management, and we will create a new replication rule. And we will call this rule CR full bucket replication. The status enabled, and this rule should apply to all objects in the bucket. And now the destination, we need to specify, and here we can specify a bucket in the same AWS account, or even sometimes you need to replicate this with another AWS account, especially when you have account, especially when you have multiple or multi-account pattern, or when you have multi-organization with multiple team. Now, this replication need a role, and the lab sheet here is giving us a ready-made role called S3-SSR role, and we need to click on save. So now the replication is basically enabled between the source and the destination bucket. And now we need to add a file, and that file should go to the first bucket in US Ohio. We will upload any file, so let me upload now any file that has no sensitive information in it, you could use any file. I'm going to upload my certificate batch, a PNG file, and then upload. So this is, could be any file that you have in your computer. So now click close. And now if you want to go and check the secondary bucket, you will find that the replication only started after the first modification. Now let us go and look at the second bucket. And this is, as I said, this will take time to see the file replicated here. And you can see now the file that I uploaded in the first bucket is automatically replicated in the second one. And let us now go to task 4, where we need to configure a file gateway and create an NFS file share. So we need to go to services, and from services, we need to go to storage gateway. And from the storage gateway, we need to create a gateway. And now that gateway, if you look here in step 20, you need to select Amazon S3 file gateway, choose an Amazon EC2, and this is basically will launch an instance. This now launch an EC2 instance, and that EC2 instance, it should be a T2X large machine. And that T2X large, we want to select a few configuration here based on the lab sheet. So the first thing we need to do is to put this T2X large on the on-premise VPC, on-premise subnet. I need to add a new volume, which is Elastic Block Storage, and this is, should be mounted in the /dev/SDB. And the size of this volume is going to be 150 with a delete on termination enabled. And we need to add tag, and we will call this name, and we will call this a file gateway appearance. Now in the security group, we want to select an existing security group. And as you can see, the lab has created for us a security group. So we need to select the on-premise as well to attach to this machine and review and launch. Now this should launch our EC2 instance. So it is in pending state. So we need to wait for it to be available. Now let us go to the AWS gateway. Once we have the EC2 machine ready, and basically this is going to be click next and choose the service endpoint, and we click next. Now we need to copy the IP address of this machine, the public IP, and paste it here in the IP address window. Now the gateway time zone is going to be GMT minus 5, and the gateway name is going to be a file gateway. And then we go and activate gateway. And then we click save and continue. On the gateway health log group, we want to disable the logging. And then we want to select finish. Now we need to wait for the file gateway status to change to running. And this is will take like 2 minutes. So as you can see now, the file gateway is ready and the status is running. So in step 49, after we managed to get the file gateway running, now what we need to do? We need to basically select the file gateway and we create a file share. And that file share is going to be, it will be first bucket -21-12-21. Now the access object is going to be an NFS, which is the default. For audit, we will keep the default. And now we click on next. Now, once you click on the next button in step 52, we want to add the Amazon S3 storage configuration to configure the following settings. The storage class is going to be standard, and we want to give bucket owner full control, and we guess the MIME type, which is the type of the objects we have, like JSON, HTML, and so on. And we need to enable request pays. This is will be disabled, which means the request of that file storage is going to pay for AWS. In our case, we are going to pay. And we need to create an IAM. So we need to paste the FGWIM policy ARN. And that basically we get it from the lab sheet. So if we go to the show, you will find there is a FGWIM policy ARN. So we're going to copy that. And we click next. Click next. Let's go back. I think we need to put the IAM here in this page. So that's the IAM role that we need to paste it here in this step. Then I click next, and then I create. So at this step here, we will monitor now the status of the deployment, and we need to wait for the status to be available. So now in task 5, we want to mount the file share to a Linux instance, and we will migrate the data. And now we need to connect to the on-premise Linux server. This means that we need to go to EC2 and get the public IP address of the Linux server. I'm going to use the lab terminal here just for simplicity, because as you know, the keys are there. .ssh labs user is there. So I'm going to call that directory and then ssh minus I labs user at pim file. .pim file, and now EC2 user is the username at the public IP of the on-premise Linux server that we have in the lab sheet created for us. Click connect, yes, and now I am inside the terminal connecting to the lab user. So I could now basically skip to step 78. So we can just, for example, see the mounted data. So if you go list command media, which is ls data, I will be able that there is a few images in that folder. Now we need to create a directory that will be used to synchronize the data with our S3 bucket using the following command. So we're going to create a new directory in the MNT NFS S3. So I'm going to copy, for some reason that command is still there, clear. So when you copy to this terminal, maybe you need to consider doing the right click and paste. And now we want to mount the file share on the Linux instance by using the command that you copied at the end of the last task. Now this is basically the command that we copy in the last task here. So it's going to be mount minus t nfs minus o no lookup hard and the IP address with the first bucket path, and then we will basically put here the mount path, which is the one we just created in the previous step. So go copy that, right click. And now we need to put this here. This is our mount target. So we're going to copy that path here and paste it in the terminal and then press enter. Let's go back and basically use the sudo because this command need a root user, and now the copy is finished. Now let us verify the file share we did, df-h, and you can see now that there is a new folder for the bucket, which is mounted to /mnt/nfs/sc3. And now that folder, we can see it is mounted correctly. So let us now in step 82, copy the data that we want to migrate to Amazon SC3 into the share by using this command. So we are going to copy all the media that we have in the media folder /data/star.png, which means I'm going to copy all the images to the destination mnt/nfs/sc3.
And now from the terminal, I managed to basically use the terminal in order to copy the data to the mnt-nfs-sc3 now. And from the sc3, we want to verify that we can see all the content of the data in the bucket. So let us go now to the first bucket. You can see all the images I copied in the previous step are here. And also, those files are replicated as well in the second bucket in the replication. So this is pretty much what you need to do for this lab. Thank you for seeing this video, and see you in the next one.